The Salazar Bridge, first sight of Lisbon for thousands of British holidaymakers who come here not by air, but by sea and car. Right underneath the bridge, the world's biggest collection of GB plates. As many as 600 a week driving onto Portuguese soil from the hold of a ship. This ship, the Eagle, Britain's biggest car ferry, fresh in from a 43-hour voyage from Southampton. In high season, the trip costs £72 per person return in a four-berth cabin and £40 for the car. Off season, with four adults travelling together, cars below 18 feet long go free. For children, it's half fare all the year round. And the Eagle's not just a car ferry, it's more of a mini cruise ship. As well as the swimming pool, there's a discotheque, casino, cinema, children's playroom with nanny, a restaurant serving the all-inclusive three meals a day, and your duty-free bars. As an alternative to the 1,200-mile, four-day drive from the Channel ports, it's a holiday en route for a holiday, and gives good value for money. But the question is, does Portugal give good value for money? And when the new arrivals leave the boat, it's a case of see Lisbon and drive. For an extra £24, you can hitch your car to a caravan for 2 weeks, fill up with petrol at an expensive 52 pence a gallon, pay a 35 pence toll and cross the Salazar Bridge, past the monument of Christ the King, heading for All Points South. In Portugal, caravanners have a choice of 65 recognised sites, and 35 are on the coast. Like this one at Sesimbra, just over 20 miles south of Lisbon. 10 years old and built on the site of a fort that was here in the 12th century, when Portugal's first king, Afonso Henriques, drove the Moors from that castle over there. Here, a family of four can set up home, with mains electricity included, for £1 a night. Or if you prefer life under canvas, 8.5 pence per person, 12 pence the tent. No charge for birds. The site has all the usual amenities, including a corner shop that boasts a bar. And there you can buy anything from a postcard to a bottle of very palatable port. And the view is all yours for free. In the days before the Salazar Bridge, Sesimbra was a typical little Portuguese fishing village. Today, it's typical of holiday Portugal, standing on the threshold of a tourist boom. Huge chunks of virgin hillside are being raped by developers in a bid to keep pace with the increasing demand for holiday accommodation. But typical, again, in that alongside the raped stand buildings that have followed a pattern of sophisticated seduction of the natural landscape. Like this hotel, the four-star Domar, custom-built to blend. Its owner is one of Portugal's leading interior decorators, and even from the exterior, it shows. A night in this hotel in high season costs the independent traveller £3 for bed and breakfast. On a package deal, 2 weeks, by air, with full board, £125. In winter, of course, it's much cheaper. Four nights with half board for £31. And it really is something to write home about. Each bedroom has its own private terrace garden. Beneath the main restaurant is the swimming pool. And beneath the swimming pool is a nightclub, waterproof, with each table commanding its own private dance floor. And how's this for the pièce de résistance? A priceless tapestry by the French artist Jean Lucas on the wall of the hotel's self-service restaurant. A serve-yourself art gallery where you can get a three-course meal, including wine, for less than £1. But for centuries, Sesimbra has been serving itself from the sea. These are the professionals. All members of a 3,500 strong armada of local fishermen who prepare by day to sail the seas by night. Despite the tourist invasion, the fishermen of Sesimbra will not be moved. They've got a job to do. And everyone, man and boy, is an expert at his craft. And these are the amateurs, holidaymakers from the nearby two-star Hotel Espadata, who are prepared to pay £10 for the privilege of joining the professionals in a 6-hour sea hunt. The £10 fee includes the hire of rods, boats, and sustenance. But you're going to need more than sustenance if you're going to catch one of these, a swordfish. You're going to need the help of a local expert like Jose Pinto Braz. Jose, what happens on a day's fishing?
Well, it's very interesting because we leave about 8 o'clock in the morning with a motorboat and some rowing boats with 3 meters. And we need to find a place about 12 miles distance, 2 hours with a motorboat. And when we arrive at the place, we try to find the bait alive because it's better alive. And after, the angler pass for the little rowing boat and we wait 3 or 4 hours that arrives the swordfish.
I've got all the equipment here. I can understand about the rod and about the food in there, but what's this for?
Well, the food is necessary because it's 5 or 6 hours on the sea, it's necessary. And the harness is very important too, because fighting a swordfish is very difficult in a little rowing boat. And you need to use the harness because we need to have the hands free to work, because never we know what happens in a little rowing boat.
Well, when the swordfish gets hold of the bait, what happens then?
Well, when they eat, they don't eat the bait. He tried to kill the bait, and after on this time, he brings the bait with the hook, and he leaves during half a minute, and after we fix the line, and we begin fighting with the swordfish.
And how long would the fight take?
Well, not less than 1 hour, and sometimes 7 hours, like the record that we have in Sesimbra, with 259 kilos.
And when you finally got the swordfish in, when it was finally dead, what happens to it when you bring it back here?
Well, when we return, the anglers, they like very much to offer the professional because they know that it's a very, very strong work. And the professional, they sell on the market fish and divided by all the krill.
So the swordfish becomes the property of the professionals?
Yes.
How much would they get for a swordfish?
Well, it's about £70 one swordfish with 100 kilos.
It's worth £70 English money?
Yeah, English money, £70.
So it's worth the professionals going out with the amateurs?
Well, you see, sometimes we go with 20 skippers, it's not too much if you caught only one.
All right, I say thank you.
Not at all.